Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. If you're running Kubernetes, you already know it can get complicated fast. Security, scaling, and multi-cluster management can quickly turn into a mess. Picture this. You have set up your Kubernetes cluster and everything's running smoothly. But then, your workload starts scaling, managing access gets chaotic, and suddenly, you're drowning in configurations. Sound familiar? Don't worry, I've been there too. That's why today, in Zero to Hero Rancher, I'm going to show you how Rancher simplifies Kubernetes, no matter where you run it, on-prem, in the cloud, or at the edge. But before we get started, make sure to hit that like button if you find this helpful, and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos on Rancher, Kubernetes, and much more. All right, let's dive in. Kubernetes is powerful, but it wasn't exactly built with simplicity in mind. The more you scale, the more complex things get. Managing access, keeping track of workloads, handling security, before you know it, you're spending more time fighting Kubernetes than actually using it. And if you're using a cloud provider managed Kubernetes service, the costs start to pile up fast. That's where Rancher comes in. Rancher is an open source Kubernetes management platform that helps you deploy, manage, and secure Kubernetes clusters, whether they are running on-prem, in the cloud, or even at the edge. Instead of juggling multiple tools, Rancher gives you a single, easy-to-use interface to manage everything in one place. One of the biggest advantages of Rancher is its flexibility. You're not locked into a single provider. You can run Kubernetes on your own hardware, in a private data center, on a Raspberry Pi at the edge, or across multiple cloud providers. Rancher gives you complete freedom. Alright, so we know Rancher can run Kubernetes anywhere, but why should you use it? What makes it better than just sticking with a cloud-managed Kubernetes service? Well, Rancher isn't just about running Kubernetes. It's about making Kubernetes work for you, not against you. Let's break down some of the biggest benefits of using Rancher. If you are running multiple Kubernetes clusters, whether they are in the cloud, on-prem, or even hybrid, managing them separately can quickly become a nightmare. Logging into multiple dashboards, keeping track of workloads, and handling updates across clusters is time-consuming and inefficient. That's where Rancher steps in. With Rancher, you get a single control plane to manage all of your Kubernetes clusters, no matter where they run. No more jumping between AWS, Azure, GCP, and on-prem setups. Everything is managed in one place. Security in Kubernetes is tricky. Managing users, setting permissions, and ensuring proper access controls can be a real headache, especially across multiple clusters. With Rancher, security is centralized and simplified. You can integrate Rancher with authentication providers like Active Directory, GitHub, LDAP, and SAML, so users can log in with their existing credentials. Plus, Rancher comes with built-in role-based access control, which lets you define who gets access to what, down to individual clusters, workloads, and namespaces. Running Kubernetes at scale means keeping an eye on performance, logs, potential failures. Rancher makes this easy by integrating monitoring and alerting out of the box with Prometheus and Grafana. This means you get real-time insights into how your clusters are performing, so you can spot issues before they become critical. Manually deploying and updating applications across Kubernetes clusters is slow and prone to errors. That's why Rancher comes with Fleet. It's built-in GitOps-powered continuous deployment system. With Fleet, you can define how applications should be deployed across multiple clusters, and any changes you push to the Git repository automatically gets deployed. This means faster rollouts, fewer human errors, and total automation. Now let's talk about cost. If you're using AWS EKS, Azure AKS, or Google GKE, you're probably paying a premium just for the privilege of having them manage your Kubernetes cluster. These services often have hidden costs like data egress fees, expensive load balancers, and per node pricing. Rancher lets you take control of your Kubernetes cost by running your own clusters wherever you want, whether it's bare metal, VMs, or a private data center. Rancher helps you cut cloud costs without sacrificing performance. So to sum it up, Rancher isn't just about running Kubernetes. It's about making Kubernetes easier, more secure, and more cost-effective. You get a single dashboard to manage everything, built-in security, advanced monitoring, full automation with Fleet, and total control over your infrastructure. And best of all, Rancher is completely open source and free to use. Enough theory. Let's see Rancher in action. In this demo, I'll show you how to set up Rancher on your local machine using Docker. You'll see just how easy it is to get started.
First, open your Linux terminal. Make sure Docker is installed and running. If you're unsure, you can check the version to confirm if it's set up correctly. Now, we will start Rancher as a Docker container. This command will pull the latest Rancher image and run it in the background. It maps ports 80 and 443, ensures the container restarts if needed, and gives Rancher the necessary privileges to function properly. Once this process is completed, we'll give Rancher a few moments to initialize. To check if it's running, list all Docker containers. You should see Rancher in the output along with its container ID and status. To make sure everything is booting up correctly, check the logs. This will show you real-time updates on Rancher's startup process. Once you see a message indicating that Rancher is up and running, you're good to go. Now switch over to your browser and navigate to HTTPS localhost. If Rancher isn't loading yet, give it a few more seconds and refresh the page. Since we are running Rancher locally without a valid SSL certificate, the browser will display a security warning. For now, just click Advanced and proceed to the site. On your first login, Rancher will ask you to set up a URL and an admin password. Before proceeding, you'll need to retrieve the bootstrap password from the container logs. Run the command displayed on the screen, copy the output, and use it to reset your password. And that's it. You now have Rancher installed and ready to go. From here, you can start adding Kubernetes clusters, managing workloads, and exploring Rancher's powerful features.
And that's just the beginning. Rancher gives you tools to take full control of your Kubernetes environment, no matter where you run it. If you found this helpful, make sure to subscribe and drop a comment with your biggest Kubernetes challenge. I'd love to cover it in a future video. Thank you.